Welcome to the James Cook University Virtual Graduation Celebration. Congratulations on your achievements. Your knowledge and experiences have prepared you to create a brighter future. Enjoy the celebrations.
Among the many good aspects of being Chancellor of my alma mater, one of the very best is presiding at graduations. Unfortunately, because of the restrictions and the disruptions caused by the global COVID-19 pandemic, we haven't been able to stage the graduation ceremony that you richly deserve. Sadly, the time-honoured tradition of gathering together with your graduating cohort, along with family and friends, and marking the occasion with ceremony and applause we'll have to wait for another time. This isn't how any of us imagined things would go, and disappointment about that is understandable. We were nevertheless determined that we would honour and celebrate your successes as well as we could. So I take great pleasure in welcoming you instead to this virtual ceremony and in congratulating you wholeheartedly on your achievements. In doing so, I also acknowledge with gratitude the family and friends whose love and support have helped bring you to this milestone in your lives. James Cook University has always been proud to celebrate the diversity of cultures and customs that make up our university community and landscape. It is very special for us to acknowledge and celebrate those deep spiritual connections through this virtual ceremony too. Indeed, I'm delighted that all awards have been distributed to graduates, including prestige awards such as university medals and medals of excellence for a doctoral research thesis. It's a matter of great pride to me that the library on our Townsville campus is named in honour of Eddie Koike Mabo. My first full-time job was in fact in that library, and I knew Koike Mabo, a humble man who played a seminal role in a nation-changing development in Australia's history. In common with the other leaders of our university, I place tremendous importance on acknowledging the contributions which Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander communities make to the broader fortunes of our community, and I pay my respects to elders past, present, and future. Reflecting on our own history as a university, JCU has played a part in many positive developments in our immediate region and across the tropics, in fulfilment of our visionary mandate to be Australia's university for the tropics. JCU has grown to be a world leader in education and research on the tropics. We have become a vibrant, multi-campus university a long way from the much humbler institution at which I commenced studies in 1968. Our graduates have made significant contributions everywhere we look, playing vital roles as business people, educators, diplomats, vice-chancellors, chancellors, health professionals, community leaders, and chief executives. In graduating today, you are joining the ranks of some very high-achieving JCU alumni. To name just a few, Professor Jamaluddin Jompa, one of Indonesia's top scientists specialising in marine and environmental science. Ms. Deb Noller, Australian female entrepreneur and CEO and co-founder of Switch Automation. Dr. Shannon Springer, one of JCU's many terrific Indigenous graduates, who is discipline lead for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Health at Bond University. Australian author and Queensland magistrate, Cathy McLennan, and our own Professor Martin Nakata, JCU's Pro Vice Chancellor. I could go on and on with impressive examples of those who have gone before you as JCU graduates making a mark in the world. But I'll let those few examples illustrate my point. Especially given that my wife Chris and I are both graduates of JCU, a particularly pleasant aspect of my role is to welcome you all, JCU's new graduates, into our alumni family. Wherever you are in the world, please do keep in touch with JCU. I and many others look forward to hearing of your adventures and successes in the future. Thank you.
As the Dean of the College of Science and Engineering, I would like to congratulate our graduates. It is a privilege and an honour to be able to address you today at this virtual celebration. To you all watching, I know this is not how you nor we envisaged this special day. Given the new realities that COVID has forced upon us, I hope this virtual ceremony can in part help serve to honour your success and achievements and acknowledge the importance of this point in your life's journey. To our college graduates, you have worked extremely hard, shown the dedication, perseverance and growth required to meet the very demanding challenges that our programs have required of you. You should be very proud of your achievements. To the parents, relatives and friends, thank you for providing the love and support required for our graduates to succeed. Your role has been key to get them to this point, and I'm sure our graduates are very appreciative of this, as are we. To our College of Science and Engineering academic, professional and technical staff who are joining us online today, thank you for sharing your wealth of knowledge and your values to equip our graduating students with the requisite skills, knowledge, critical and innovative thinking to now go out into this ever-changing world to meet and overcome the challenges that are presenting us now and into the future. Your degree from James Cook University and the College of Science and Engineering is highly valued on the local, national and international stages. Your degree has been developed and delivered by our staff who are constantly acknowledged and rewarded for their research and teaching excellence. Indeed, the College of Science and Engineering is the powerhouse of research within the university. Each discipline is measured by the Australian Government for its research excellence and impact. The highest ranking is in ERA 5, and in this latest round, the College of Science and Engineering was responsible for 9 of the 10 ERA 5s awarded to James Cook University. Likewise, our professional degrees are industry informed, industry engaged, and industry supported, and our graduates are highly sought after by industry. Graduates, congratulations once again. Take the time today to look back upon this journey at James Cook University and celebrate what you have achieved. It has been a pleasure for our academic staff, our professional and technical teams to take you on this journey. There are some big challenges that confront our society. The world needs you to reimagine and innovate to address these challenges, and science and engineering will be at the forefront of solutions to these challenges. It is one of the key motivating and rewarding elements of this job to follow the evolving careers and outstanding achievements of our graduates, and I look forward to following the graduating class of 2020. Finally, I say, stay in touch, stay safe, and my very best wishes for the exciting journey that awaits you.
On behalf of myself and the staff and faculty of the College of Business Law and Governance, I want to congratulate you on achieving this significant milestone in your lives and careers. It's a shame we can't be all together to celebrate your success. However, in these difficult times, you've demonstrated commitment, adaptability, and resilience. Nurture these attributes as they will hold you in good stead as you embark on your career now and in the future. In the United States and many other countries, this is not a graduation ceremony, but a commencement ceremony. Orrin Hatch, a US senator, once said, "There's a good reason they call these ceremonies commencement exercises. Graduation is not the end, it's the beginning." And this is true, as today signifies the commencement of your new chapter in your lives. Milton Berle, a US comedian, once said, "If opportunity doesn't knock, build a door." And by completing your degree, you've built that door, and now you can open it and explore the exciting opportunities that lie beyond. There's no doubt that we face unprecedented challenges today and in the future, but I'm confident that you have the knowledge and skills to not only meet these challenges, but to contribute to finding the solutions. Don't be afraid to challenge the norms and strive to make change. Always look forward and work towards what you believe in. There will be failures along the way, but persistence, resilience, and a belief in yourself will guide you forward along your chosen path. Remember, J.K. Rowling, the author of the Harry Potter books, was rejected 12 times, but persistence and perseverance finally paid off, and she's now one of the most well-known and loved authors of our time. But today is about you and the now. Today, we celebrate your truly great achievement, and you should be justifiably proud. I know we are.
Hello and welcome to this very unusual celebration of graduation. We have graduates across all our campuses, in Singapore, Townsville, Cairns, and some in Brisbane as well, across all our disciplines in our college, including education, social work, creative arts, humanities, and social sciences. Over 600 graduates in all. I just want to spend a couple of moments reflecting on the importance of the discipline areas of our college. There is nothing more important than educating our young people to face the futures that are very uncertain for them. We also support communities through social work. The creative arts prepares students to consider how to reflect our societies and the problems that we encounter in them. The humanities and social sciences look deeply into what it is to be human and how to deal with the challenges of the world. All of these are critical areas at this time. So I would like to thank you all for coming, for the work you've done, the over 600 graduates around our various campuses. Thank you very much to the staff who have supported the students throughout their work, and to the families who I know contribute enormously to the success of our students. Thank you all.
It is my absolute joy today to greet all of you who are graduating from the College of Healthcare Sciences. I know it's been an interesting year for each and every one of you, and it's sad that I can't be with you and see you personally, but please understand that every single one of you who are graduating this year are rock stars. You've had a really interesting year with COVID, and despite everything that's happened to you, every one of you now are celebrating the end of your degree, and you will be graduating from JCU, and you will be heading off into your newfound careers, some of you, and some of you who are finishing master's degrees will be moving on with those careers in much better ways. As I've said to you, it's been a challenging year for you, I know, and all I can say is how proud I am that you've moved through that year. You've moved through the last 3, 4, 5 years of your course, and you've come to the end of it now. You all need to be celebrating yourself and each other. You need to be celebrating with your family and your friends because you've made it, guys. Once again, I'll say I'm incredibly proud of each and every one of you, and I wish you all the best with your careers from this day forward. Some of you I know I'll see again, because you'll come back to JCU and you'll be doing some further studies to once again enhance your careers. So having said all that, I just want to finish this conversation with you today by saying I applaud you all. Well done. Thank you very much.
To my fellow graduates, welcome to James Cook University, Singapore's virtual graduation celebration. My name is Aditya Subhash, and it is my privilege and honor to speak on behalf of all graduating students. While this is a virtual event, it does not one bit diminish the great importance and sanctity of a graduation ceremony. I am 100% sure each one of us takes immense pride in participating in this program. This simply demonstrates how strong and resilient we are as people, that in spite of the setbacks due to the pandemic, we have marched forward in pursuit of our goals, objectives, and dreams. My dear fellow graduates, we are testimony to this as we graduate during these trying times. Our success and achievements has come due to a lot of hard work, sacrifices, late hours, and maybe sometimes loneliness in these times with the limited social interactions. But this would have not been possible but for the sacrifices made by our parents, guardians, sponsors, and dear ones, for which we are immensely grateful for. No amount of words are enough to express our sincere gratitude to them. I would also like to give a big shout out to the friends that we have made through our course, clubs, and societies. I'm grateful for the friendships that I've forged through the Masters in IT program here in James Cook University, Singapore. I would like to take this opportunity to thank my supervisor and professor, Dr. Insoo Song, for his invaluable mentorship and encouragement. Additionally, I would also like to thank all of JCU administration who have always been selfless and very considerate towards the needs of the students, and always being there to help when it matters. A special shout out to the team who helped with seamless online classes, assessments, and examinations. I think I speak for everyone when I say that we are extremely grateful to the people who make up this wonderful institution. From the housekeepers, to the faculty, to the administration, to the JCU staff, and the IT staff. We will always be grateful to all of you for making JCU a conducive place to learn and study, and for sharing your wisdom, expertise, and experience with us. The education and the learning we have undertaken here in JCU has prepared us well to step into the next phase of our life with great confidence. Of course, there will be a lot of uncertainty and challenges that we will face in the marketplace. But I am sure we are well prepared to face and surmount all those challenges with success. Guys, we have graduated, but continuous learning and upgrading our skills will be the mantra to success. Congratulations, my dear friends and fellow graduating students. I wish us great success in all endeavors. God bless and cheers.
Graduates, you have achieved something important, really something mighty. You have stayed the course and met the requirements of your degree program, and you enter the world in a new way, as a graduate, a James Cook University graduate, now a member of the JCU alumni. You deserve my best congratulations and those of everyone in your life. Well done, graduates, very well done. Second, I acknowledge and congratulate your parents, family, friends, and supporters who will be watching to see you being recognised for your achievement. On an occasion that seems like it is all about you, I hope you will take a moment to think about them. In many ways, your parents' job over many years, from the time you were born, has been to practice letting you go. Until you are a parent or grandparent or carer, you cannot know what this letting go is like, watching you grow and achieve, seeing you struggle and succeed, and not knowing how or if they can help while hoping you make choices worthy of you. That watching is joyful and hard and sad and wonderful all at once. Your other family members, your partner, friends and supporters have had a similar job, to be there with you and for you, to help you along your way as best they can, but to let you be who you are, who you want to be. Graduates, my point is that this letting go is a very difficult task, and all these people who have loved and supported you as long as they have known you deserve my best congratulations for all they have done for you, and they deserve yours too. Please ensure you take a moment soon to tell them so, for surely you wouldn't be here without them. Your professors and lecturers and the professional and technical staff of the university have also watched you develop. Our job has been to guide and help you as you work towards achieving your qualification. So I congratulate and thank my university colleagues for the important role they have played on your educational journey. Know that we are here to help you as best we can, but we are also in the business of letting you go to develop and grow from here. Graduates, in the spirit of letting you go, it is your choices from here that I want to speak briefly with you about. I put it to you that today, as you watch from wherever you are, and for the rest of your professional life, there are two critical questions facing you. How you choose to respond to them is up to you and you alone. Together, your response, what you choose, will determine your life's course. Here's the first question. Can you do what needs to be done? Can you do what needs to be done? Now, answering this question might seem easy. By virtue of your success in completing your degree program, you have a solid knowledge and skills base to practice as a professional in your field. In order to be able to do what needs to be done, in order to serve as a professional, you will need to build on that base throughout your career. You will need to make learning and development your constant companion. This is vital. Graduates, I don't doubt that you can do this, that you can do what needs to be done if you choose. But here's my second question. Graduates, will you do what needs to be done? Will you do what needs to be done? If your professional life from here is like most others, most of your days will be fairly routine. And on those routine days, you will do what needs to be done quite easily and meet others' needs as required. But graduates, there is nothing surer than this. From time to time, among those many routine days, there will be days of extraordinary intensity and hard choices. What you choose to do at these times, these most difficult of times, is full of meaning for those who are depending on you and for you as a professional and as a person. It is in these moments that you will need to find your will to do what needs to be done. Making the choice to do what needs to be done when it is hard and you'd rather not, when you yourself might be criticised or feel at risk, will test your courage and your strength. Making the choice to do what needs to be done in these moments will test your honesty and your humility. It will test your ethics and your integrity. It will test your worth as a professional. But most of all, making the choice to do what needs to be done will test who you really are and who you have become. Your choice at those moments, and those moments will come to you, your choice at those most difficult moments will define you as a professional and as a human being in this world. Graduates, your parents, loved ones, friends and supporters will continue to do all they can for you. By means of their love and support for you, they have chosen you and all you promise. As hard as it is, they are doing their best to let you go, to make your own choices from here, for you to decide what sort of professional, what sort of person you will become. Now it is time for you to choose. Will you commit to doing what needs to be done, easy or not, whether you want to or not? Will you do this and set your life's course to become the professional, to become the person you were always meant to be? Graduates, I urge you to think deeply on this. If you can make this choice, if you will commit to doing what needs to be done, know this: the world will be a better place for you having lived in it. Graduates, choose wisely. Goodbye and good luck.
As JCU's Director of Advancement, I'm fortunate to lead JCU's Alumni Relations Team. On behalf of the Alumni Association, I'd like to congratulate you upon your graduation and to welcome you to JCU's growing family of almost 100,000 alumni around the world. As a new member of the Alumni Association, I invite you to stay in touch with us over the coming months and years. We're keen to hear about your accomplishments and your career milestones. When we're all able to travel again, I hope I have a chance to meet you at one of the many alumni functions we hold around the world. In the meantime, visit jcu.edu.au/alumni, follow us on Facebook, and make sure to connect with us on LinkedIn. Again, let me join the chorus of those wishing you all the best as you move on to this next chapter in your life. Congratulations.